I just want to be left alone.
I'm a social worker here at HKU and I'm here to help you.
No, I don't want anyone to help.
You getting your feelings off your chest is not going to bother me at all. It's important to talk about it. Is it a buckling, you know?
Thank you. Today.
Hello everyone, I'm Henry. Today we are going to discuss the education system in Hong Kong. Can you please introduce yourself first?
Hi everyone, I'm Robert.
I'm Chris.
Hello, I'm Sophia.
I'm wondering why you have a girl name.
Oh, actually I'm a girl, a trans woman.
Oh, I understand. I think the education system in Hong Kong is exam-oriented. In Form 4, teacher already forced us to do many past papers to get good grades.
Yes, I agree with you. Not only the past paper, but the teacher might also use students' holidays to hold more supplementary classes to train us. I remember my summer holiday in Form 5, although I have around 40 days of holiday, but excluding the supplementary classes, there are only 5 days of holidays. So, do you have more ideas on it?
Yeah, apart from this, the education system of Hong Kong lacks sexual education. Teachers won't always want us to enter a good university like the HKU. The curriculum in secondary school only focuses on examination skills and recitation. However, students in Hong Kong need an all-rounded education.
I think he makes a good point.
Sorry, it should be she.
Yeah, I know it should be he. Let's go on.
Hey, have you heard that? Is she?
That's a bit disrespectful, please.
Please show some respect.
Hey, don't be too serious, okay? Let's keep this thing to what you said, okay?
Hey, sweetie, do you know how beautiful you are? I mean, look at you. Your eyes, your face, your legs. You're obsessed with me.
Your eyes to be your
love magnet. Do you got any plans for tonight? Maybe we can go on a little date?
No,
oh my god, what is happening with your voice? Why is it so deep? Are you singing something?
Going to a counselor or therapist?
No, I don't think it's worth it. It happens all the time.
That doesn't mean it's okay, because you deserve to be treated like a human being.
No, I just want to be there about it.
I understand it's painful to talk about, but bottling up your emotions will only make it worse.
Okay, maybe you're right.
You should think of coping strategies to help you. You must know what happened. It wasn't your fault, and you don't deserve to be treated like that.
Thank you for understanding. I really appreciate it.
If you ever experience anything like that again, make sure to talk to me or someone else in
case.
I was so upset last time when Chris kept using the wrong pronoun of his brother.
The topic of today is education about international feminism. And I have done some research on it, realizing that there are various ways to each woman experience discrimination. I should stand out and help Sophia get out of this. For example, this woman called Rita is an ambitious black Muslim woman seeking a career path in law. She posts a video about how women are discriminated against by their race, gender, and religion in the law office. Although this video grabbed many views and likes on Twitter, around half of the comments are hatred, including foul language.
Commendably, only a few people would like to stand up and fight back for her. Not only Rita, but I also see another woman called Leila, who is an older Chinese-American trans woman, feminist activist working in Taipei, Hong Kong. After posting tweets on Twitter about colleagues calling her a monster, more conservative male users use Cantonese foul language to attack her and tell her suicide.
The situation is pathetic. Feminism is not only about females having more rights and opportunities than males.
I agree.
He makes a great point.
It's really fantastic. Our topic is about international feminism, and you did just do discriminating against Sophia.
Mind your words, it's really hurtful.
Say sorry to Sophia.
Okay, guys, I apologize, okay? Sophia, I'm really, really sorry, okay?
Thank you for speaking out for me just now. I know there must be someone in the world who doesn't understand why we are doing this. And I also couldn't understand myself back then and hated myself very much. And I was so confused when I realized that I identified myself more as a girl than a boy. And it takes a huge courage to come back to my friends and parents.
How unlucky, the disgusting feminine world again.
The body belongs to me and I can do whatever I want and I don't know what I did wrong. You, sexual harasser, if you still say this word to me, I will call the police and arrest you.
It doesn't cost us anything as men for women to do well. We don't lose out because more women are empowered. It just makes the world better, said John Legend, a famous musician. Intersectional feminism is not only about eliminating discrimination against women of different backgrounds, but also a belief that encourages everybody to have the same rights and privileges. Everyone is responsible for creating an inclusive society by acquiring the correct sexual knowledge and mindset. More importantly, we should listen to and elevate marginalised people's voices to eradicate systematic bias and discrimination. This way, we can move towards a more just future for everyone.